Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with the routing algorithms concept. So in the previous video I just show you what are the different routing algorithms. So in that, the first one is a static routing algorithm. So the static routing algorithm are of three types. One is a shortest path routing algorithm, flooding, and flow based routing algorithm. So in this video we'll just I'll just explain you what is a shortest path routing algorithm. So let me write that shortest path routing algorithm. So I said this is a static one, so starting itself you need to design the path. So it finds the main concept of the shortest path routing algorithm is, so in the name itself we are having shortest path, we have to select the shortest distance from source to the destination. If you want to transfer the packet over a network from source to the destination, you need to find the shortest path. So it finds the shortest path between a given pair of route, a given pair of routers, that is from source and destination, what is the shortest path? So that we have to be find out. So the cost of link may be a function of, so whatever the here is a router and another router is there, so we need to find out the shortest path from one node to another node, like that, something. So it has to reach its destination. So here this is a link from one node to another node, these are the links. So here the cost of the link may be a function of distance. Let me write that the cost of the link. The cost of link from one node to the another may be a function of distance, bandwidth, or average traffic between the nodes, and the communication cost, even you can calculate the delay etc. So these are all the functions of the finding out the cost of a link. The cost of a link may be a function of distance, bandwidth, average traffic, communication cost, and delay. Now let's see one of the example of the shortest path routing, how we are going to find out the shortest path routing. So for that I'm taking the example as Dijkstra algorithm. The example for finding out the shortest path is Dijkstra algorithm. So I already explained this concept, Dijkstra algorithm, in while I'm discussing the design analysis and algorithms. So here in this networking concept also, we will use the same example to find the shortest path. Okay, now let's see what is this Dijkstra algorithm. So here I have taken, this is a source. So this I'm calling it as a source. And here this D is the destination. I want to reach the packet, forward the packet from source to the destination. So which route I have to be selected? So that is a concept. And here I have to select the shortest path. How can I choose the shortest path from A to D? So here the source node, and assume the starting A node cost is 0. Let us assume the cost of A node is 0. Starting, let's assume it is 0. And remaining all are at infinite. So here in step 1, you just see the concept. I'm explaining step by step. In the step 1, so we want to find the shortest path from A to D. Okay, Just please keep a concentration here so that you can easily understand how we are going to find out the shortest path. So first, we want to find the shortest path from A to D. So initially, no paths are known. So you don't know paths, the different paths you don't know. So all nodes are at infinite. So this is all nodes, just keep as infinite. And the starting node, the cost is zero. Just assume. So here the cost of first node, source node, is zero, and the remaining all are infinite because you don't know the cost. Coming to the second step. In the second step, node A is working node. So whenever the node is working, you just mark it as dark. So node A is working node. So and make it as a permanent. So just make it as a dark so that A node is permanent. Means the path is permanent. Examine adjacent nodes of A. So just examine what are the adjacent nodes of A, B and G. Okay, the adjacent nodes of A are B and G. So examine adjacent nodes of A and relabeling each one with a distance to A. So from A to B 2 and A to G is 6. So just relabeling. So replace the infinite with that cost B 2 of A. So it came from A. So that's why I make it as a 2 comma A. And G is 6 comma A. So because you know the cost of from A to G, so just relabeling infinite with 6 comma A. Okay, so now coming to the third step, we make B with smallest label. So here, which is the smallest one? 2 and 6, which one is the smallest path? 2 is the smallest path. So whenever the 2 is the smallest path, just select the B and mark it as a permanent. So now this root is permanent. So we make B with the smallest label permanent. Now B is the new working node. Now B becomes the new working node. So repeat the step. Now we make, coming to the step 4. We examine B. Now examine B because this is a working node. Examine B adjacent nodes. So what are the adjacent nodes of B? C and E. C and E. So what are the values for the C and E? 7 and 2. Just mark here. And relabeling the each one with a distance of E. So from B to C, it is 9 comma B. And from B to E, it is 4 comma B. Why it is 4 comma B? Because already 2, A to B, it reaches 2. 2 plus 2, 4. Okay. So actually the cost of from B to E is only 2. But if I travel from this side to here, the cost of B is 2 and the distance from B to E is 2. So 2 plus 2, 4. 4 comma B. And here why it is 9? The cost of B is 2 and distance from C to B is 7. 7 plus 2, 9. So just relabeling the infinite with 9 comma B and 4 comma B because this node comes from the B. Okay, so this is step 4. In the step 5, just make E with the smallest label. So in this 2, which one is the smallest? 4 or 9? So 4 is the smallest. So just make E as a permanent node. In the step 5, mark E as a permanent node. Okay, so we make E as the smallest label permanent. Now E becomes the new working node. Now here you check in step 6. So from E, what are the adjacent nodes from E? So B is already visited. So just discard. So F and G from these two. These are the two adjacent nodes. So the cost of the distance from E to F is 2 and from E to G is 1. So in the problem, they are given. So here, we examine adjacent nodes of E and relabeling each one with distance. So I just relabeling this. So here the cost of E is 4 and the distance is 2. So 4 plus 2, 6. And here the cost is 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Okay. So again check in the step 7. So what is the cost of the F and G. So here it is 6 and here it is 5. So we make G with the smallest. So here G is the smallest. So we examine, we make G with the smallest label and mark it as a permanent. So now just mark G as a permanent. Why I make it as a permanent? Because it is the smallest when compared to the F, G is the smallest. And mark it as a permanent. And repeat the same process. So in the step 8, we examine the adjacent node of G. Now examine the adjacent node of G. What are the adjacent nodes? E and H. So E is already visited. So go for the H. Okay. So just examine. So from G, the cost of distance from G to H is 4. So 5 plus 4, 9. Okay. 5 plus 4, 9. Coming to the step 9. In the step 9, we make F with the smallest label. Why? So even though we are reached the H, the cost of H is 9 and the cost of F is 6. When compared to these two, this F is the smallest. So we make F as a permanent. So from H and F, F is the smallest. So mark it as a permanent. So now what are the permanents node? A, B, E, okay, F or the permanent, okay, and these are all the permanent. So just permanent nodes has to be keep dark. Now F is a working node. Now in the step 9, we examine adjacent nodes of F. So what are the adjacent nodes of F? C and H. Okay, C and H. So we make H with the smallest. So here the distance from C to F to C is 3. So 6 plus 3, 9. And here 6 plus 2, 8. So from these two, which one is the smallest one? 8 is the smallest one. So now make H as a permanent. So here, so the permanent nodes make it as a dark. H as a permanent. So we make H with the smallest label permanent and H becomes the new working node. So now from here you just check. The adjacent nodes of H is D. Okay. So we examine each node of the adjacent nodes of H. So F is already visited. Okay. And just relabeling the D, which is the adjacent node of H. So the distance is 2. 8 plus 2, 10. 10, F. Now next, coming to the next step. 13. So now we coming to the C. C, you didn't make it as a permanent. So just coming to the C. So we examine C with the smallest label. So what is the smallest label of the here? So from these here, just we make C. So we make C with the smallest label permanent and C becomes the new working node here. So from these two here, C is a working node. So now what are the adjacents of the C? Now, we examine each node adjacent to the C and relabeling each with the distance of C. So, 9 plus, just replace with the C. So, here 9 plus 3 becomes 10. No, 9 plus 3 becomes what? It's a 12. But here 8 plus 2, 10. So, just select them. We examine each node adjacent to C and relabeling each one with the distance to the C. Okay. And in the step 15, we make D as a permanent with the smallest label. D becomes the working node now. So, here the concept is, up to now we are just find the distance, the cost of the distance from one node to the another node. So, we replaced all the infinite values with the smallest path. Only smallest path. Now, here you need to select the path. So with the help of the smallest values, here you need to find out the path. So far you are just make visit all the nodes and all the nodes you are find it the cost of the each node. Now from this you need to find the root. So from A, what is the smallest? 2 or 5? The adjacent of A is B and G. What is the smallest value? 2 or 5? 2 is the smallest. Okay, so from here C and E, which is the smallest? 9 or 4? 9 is the smallest. So from here 5 and 6. Okay, if you go here again, you have to come back, visit the same route. So from this, suppose if you go here, so this is the smallest. So just visit the F. So from F, these two are the adjacent nodes. From these two adjacent node 9 and 8, which one is the smallest? H is the smallest. And from D. Okay, so this is the newest path, shortest path to reach the destination. So this method you call it as a Dijkstra algorithm. Thank you.